Let me begin with biodiversity. It refers to the relationship between species and the habitat. India is a mega biodiversity country. Here, each species plays a unique role. Vulture is one such species which plays a very important role in protecting our environment. Unfortunately, they are now fighting a losing battle for survival. It is high time that the government and society to come forward to protect the king of the food pyramid, the vultures, from extinction. Almost two decades ago, vulture population was more than 85 million in India. Today, it is left with only 3 to 4 thousand. Vultures have shown the fastest decline in any bird population since the dodo. Now, finds its place in the Red Data Book, which contains a list of species whose continued existence is threatened. The International Union for Conservation of Nature has put it at par with the tigers in the most critically endangered list. The rate of decline has been huge, 48% annually, and almost 99% of the species vanished from the blue skies during the last 12 years. It is a matter of great shame for the mankind if we are unable to protect these birds. These majestic birds are the nature's most effective and as vultures in order to efficiently dispose of their deaths through sky barriers at the Tower of Silence. Another interesting revelation of vulture study has been that the amount of carcass cleaned by them in the environment is astronomical, around 20 million tons annually. But the sudden crash in vulture population has led to increase in dangerous diseases, increase in feral dog population, and has devastated the rapid carcass disposal mechanism to around 99%. I interacted with Nandankanan Zoo authorities associated with vulture conservation and breeding. I was confirmed that diclofenac is the major cause of decline in the vulture population. During the super cyclone of 1999 in Orissa, vultures ended up consuming a large number of casualties treated with diclofenac. Besides, the cyclone also destroyed their nesting habitats. The only solution to this grave problem is replacement of diclofenac by meloxicam, widely used in the West as a safe alternative drug. Use of meloxicam can protect the existing vulture population. The benefits from this effort are many and all encompassing. The massive, continuous, and the fast cleaning of the carcasses by the vultures keeps the environment clean. It reduces the risk of dangerous diseases like rabies and anthrax and controls the rapid increase in the feral dog population. Creation of vulture safe zones promotes tourism, providing livelihood to local communities, protecting vultures and ensuring a diclofenac free zone. Establishment of Jatayu Restara, providing safe food to the vultures from cow shelters consisting of old cattle purchased from the owners at a nominal price. Vulture population can be revived by breeding in captive breeding centers and in open in vulture safe zones. To establish vulture conservation breeding center, approximate expenditure is around ₹100 lakhs. To establish vulture safe zone, approximate expenditure is around ₹5 lakhs. Stakeholders like government, NGOs, and the pharmaceutical companies can contribute towards the success of this mission, Project Jatayu. Already, ban on diclofenac has been imposed since March 2005, but its use and manufacture continues even today. So legislative action needs to be taken in order to completely phase out diclofenac in any form. Separate budget to be provided for ex situ, in situ breeding centers and research. Regular monitoring of the effectiveness. Ministry of HRD to seriously start thinking of incorporating a chapter on vulture conservation in the school curriculum. NGOs can play a crucial role in intensifying vulture conservation campaigns targeting the vets, farmers and the pharmaceutical companies. International Vulture Awareness Day to be celebrated meticulously in support of this effort. Financial support to be given by the NGOs. NGOs can also start Jatayu clubs. Out of 110 pharmaceutical companies in India, 25 companies manufacture 45 formulations of diclofenac exclusively for the veterinary sector. So they should immediately ban diclofenac and start manufacturing meloxicam. They should also contribute at least 1% of their profit towards Project Jatayu. A truckload of thanks to these people and institutions, including Team IIMT and my faculty mentor, Mrs. Minati Mahapatra. Finally, before ending, let us remember that in nature, there are neither rewards nor punishments. There are only consequences. Thank you.